Wow. So that's another, that's impressive, okay? What's up, everyone? Welcome to the Durbin Compound. Today we have a special episode because we are looking at a very niche market here with a dustless table saw. So I have just unpacked this table saw, just got out of the parts out on the table, and I am here making the review for you guys. So if we're meeting for the first time, my name is Devin Durbin, and I'm here to bring you the tools, tips, and tricks to make you more self-sufficient. So this table saw is definitely set up for those people that are looking for a dustless solution. So if you've ever had a job site table saw or a table saw in general, they usually spit sawdust right in your face, especially on the jobs that I use them. I'm using them for laminate and hardwood and doing some intricate cuts where I need to rip the board. And it would be a great solution to have something inside the home or maybe inside a home that's already framed in and drywalled, and you're not making excessive dust. This might be an awesome solution for a finished carpenter or an all-around handyman that just needs to get stuff done right then and there. So I am going to bring you guys in close. We're going to go over some features of this that I note. I want to go ahead and thank you for Sirocco for sending this saw for review. This is a paid promotion in that they did send me a saw and want my honest opinion on that. So if you guys send anything to the Durbin Compound for review, you better be prepared for the truth, good, bad, or indifferent. So this saw is by no means the absolute creme de la creme when it comes to fit and finish. But I don't expect that from this saw. I expect their 98.5% dustless to be pretty much 98.5% dustless. I don't really care about fit and finish when it comes to that. I really don't need a precision job site table saw. I really don't. And anybody that says they really need a precision job site table saw is just full of themselves because they don't need to make crazy precise cuts if you're moving your saw around. So you have a cabinet saw, you have a shop saw for those precision cuts. This is for stuff in the field that you're ripping down or you're trying to make a rough cut with and get close. So the fact that the fit and finish is, you know, not up to par with something like a saw stop or a high-end DeWalt or, you know, some of the higher end job site table saws is perfectly fine because this is in a different bracket. So this saw will cost you $299 and you can get them at Walmart. You can get them a couple different places. I'll put some links below, but for $299, so far, this is a pretty darn good saw. I don't expect a whole lot for $300, but it's definitely got some good features. The one feature that I do like that I would like to note here is that the saw has its vacuum system completely integrated into it. And that's ideal for me because I don't want to hang around and screw around with the shop vac while I'm also trying to set up the saw. So let me turn this around for you guys. And so hopefully you can see this good in camera. What I'll do is I'll come around here and I'll show you. We'll zoom in here a little bit. So the mechanism in the back here is basically in line with the motor and the arbor. Before the arbor, it has this this chamber. Basically, I would think of it as like a turbocharger where it basically creates suction off the motor. There's probably an impeller in here and it creates suction off the impeller. And then it directs it over here into a bag. So the bag goes on to the side and just comes off with a little elastic band. So one thing that I would like to see is maybe a metal clamp around here to hold this bag on, but we have not ran the saw yet, so it'll probably hold up just fine. But I'd like to see a more permanent fixation here because as you move the saw around, you can easily catch the bag and pull it off this little plastic piece here. But I love that it's integrated all into one. That's really cool to me. I don't have to haul around the saw and the shop vac. That's really good. So some other features that I wanted to go over was this dust shield over the blade. I'm gonna change the camera angle and show you guys this. All right, so now you're up here looking at the top of the saw here. This is one of the most intricate dust shields I've ever seen on a blade set up like this. So you have your riving knife back here, and you can change out the riving knife. They have a riving knife that has no dust collection on it, a standard riving knife, okay? Or you have this riving knife for your dust collection. So it has fins back here to allow for dust collection to be held right around the blade. And then you also have two front guards. So basically every kickback system that's sold on a job site table saw like this has the plastic kickback, plastic things like this, and usually some teeth to hold for a kickback at the bottom or at the back. But none have a plastic piece that holds tight against the blade. That's probably how they're getting quite a substantial amount of dust collection out of this. So if you remove this, and you can remove your little panel in here for changing the blade, I think you're at a good vantage point to see this cover in here. So this cover is definitely an important piece to have in here for dust collection. So it keeps the amount of dust created in here down to a minimum. It keeps it tight against the blade. So what's good about that is it's not a whole area in here. On the DeWalt, I'm moving my hands all kind of crazy. In a DeWalt saw, there's just a bag in here. It's kind of like a canvas bag. After a while of moving the saw up and down, it rips, and then you never get good dust collection out here. This is a plastic tray here. It looks like it's basically milled out of plastic. It looks like it's a block of plastic and then they milled it out. But it goes down in beside the blade and keeps that dust collection tight. That's probably another reason why they can get such good dust collection out of it. The DeWalt is just a big open bay here, and your shop vac is only as good as what it can suck through that large area. So if you know anything about airflow, the tighter gap that you have in airflow, the more velocity you can get through there. So that's how they probably do a pretty darn good job of dust collecting. All right, coming down to the front of the saw here, you know, a lot of people say that, you know, I'm a fanboy and stuff, and I get really excited about reviews. And, you know, since this is a paid promotion, like, I'm getting paid to say this. And, like, I'm not getting paid to say one way or the other. I just have reasonable expectations about a piece of equipment. This is a $299 saw. This is not going to be the absolute greatest thing known to man. A lot of people would expect a $300 saw to be a fit and finish of a $1,000 saw or a $2,000 saw, and they want everything for nothing. This is pretty darn good for the price point market that they're in. They have a stick-on tape measure here that's probably pretty close. If it's not all that close, you've got the ability to move your little plastic indicator here. Like, okay, if it didn't have a movable plastic indicator, yeah, that would be a point to hit this saw on. But I can't hit the saw on it because even though it's a tape-on-tape measure, you can dial it in. Piece of cake. Just takes a little bit of extra time. This little, for the bevel adjustment, now I will say that this bevel adjustment to get to this turn knob is a little hard to get your hand back in here, but how else would you do it? DeWalt has a cam lock. The cam lock is probably pretty expensive, makes the price go up. So, you know, the cam lock is not that bad, or the this turn wheel here is not that bad, but, you know, it's just little things like that, like, hey, if I had to fight with that all the time, yeah, maybe be a big deal. This also has an indicator on it, so that you can move it around and line it up precisely. So when you set your blade up, you can put a degree caliper on it and you can line it up to absolute zero and then tighten the Phillips screw down. Like, seriously, have reasonable expectations for your piece of equipment. Nice thing I like about this is the switches on here. This is a very nice button system. So I really like this. I really like the button that they picked. I think it's a very solid contact and it feels very good. So that's an option that I really like. This handle could be a little bit better. Is it a little cheap? Yeah, it could be a little better. The knob is nice and sturdy here, but this handle is a little cheap. So maybe making it a shorter handle and making it more robust is something better to do. The bolt really doesn't move. It's this plastic handle that moves around the bolt. So reasonable expectations. Once again, it's not that bad. It'll do for what I'm using it for. It'll do for a $300 table saw. Now, I plan on taking this saw to job sites in the future, so you'll probably see upcoming episodes on this saw, and you'll see some pros testing this out. I'm gonna put it in the hands of some professionals. We're gonna get with some local contractors and get it in the hands of some professionals so that we can get some real live feedback and not just me talking on the camera, because, you know, I get paid to say good things, right? Yeah. So let's go ahead and put this back to zero. I don't really care if it's perfectly zero or not. I'll put the dust collection back on. Oh, one thing to note that I didn't earlier was that this pin here will set the tube up either way you want to put it on the saw. So you can put it on this side. If you needed to cut something further off to the left, you have plenty of room. If you need to put it over here, you put it so you have plenty of room off this side. So there are options, even though this tube is on here, there are options. So let's go ahead and make sure there's no crazy bends in this here, and let's run a board through it. All right, put my eyes and my ears on. Make sure you got your ears on too. Make sure you got your PPE on there standing behind the saw. All right, so I'm gonna run the big board. I'm gonna have my hands way far away from the blade just for all you keyboard warriors out there. Okay, so something to note up here is that when I was down here at eye level with the blade, I did get a little bit of kickback with a couple pieces of dust, but otherwise very, very little. Here on the table, no visible dust whatsoever from those cuts. So pretty darn good. I don't see any dust flying around in the air. When I get through recording this and take it into edit, we'll see how much dust flew at the camera or that you could see on camera. But I otherwise don't see any dust in the air like my DeWalt. Even when I was down here, I don't have much dust on me, as I'm literally right in front of the camera or right in front of the saw. So I have a little bit of dust on me, a little bit of sawdust, but not all that bad. I mean, it definitely could be worse. If I was running my DeWalt saw like that, oh my goodness, I would be covered. So it's definitely a substantial improvement on other systems. I one day might come up with a video to, definitely get the numbers on exactly how many particle counts are in the air. Maybe we can prove that 98% dustless. Maybe we don't. But I'm overall pretty darn impressed with a saw that's $300 and that offers me a pretty darn good dust collection system for what you get here. So, and we do have some dust inside our bag here. That's what, just from two cuts. So it definitely sucked up a lot of dust. A nice thing about this bag is that they do have the plastic slip off here, and then it's wide open at the end. So let me dump the rest of it out here. Wow. So that's impressive. Okay. So no visible dust on the tabletop, all that dust in the bag, and very little dust on me, even though I was standing literally right in front of the blade, probably one of the more dangerous places to stand with my face, but I don't really care what the keyboard warriors say. But it's pretty darn impressive. So I give it a 2 thumbs up. I mean, it definitely hits this niche market of wanting to be dustless and operate this inside. It's definitely two thumbs up in that category. Could it be a little bit better built? Could it have better options and better things? Yeah, but it'll cost you a lot more than just $300. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Give my video a thumbs up or a thumbs down because I ran it really unsafely. Or, you know, hopefully you subscribe to the channel. Hopefully you see this saw in more videos in the future. And we'll see you guys in the next video.